Fidel Center?
This is where all the administrative buildings are, career services, registrars, GraceLife. You'll probably be spending a lot of time here if you're an incoming freshman. You have to do a lot of just paperwork and validation is all here in Fidel. A lot of people hang out here. This is also where the cafeteria is, Chartwell's. It's known for having very tasty food. There's also just like a lounge area inside Fidel, and just probably one of the newer buildings on campus. It's really good, really pretty looking, I think. And we're gonna go inside and I'm gonna show you around. Right now, actually, I think there's some kind of massage time going on that you'll be seeing a lot of students getting massages. I don't know, I guess that's for finals. So, massage behind us for finals week. There's people are getting free massages, I guess, from all the stress. Also, here that happens in the Fidel Center is the career fair and the club fair. So, career fair actually happens upstairs. But the club fair is all the clubs, they put out booths and they just have kind of, you know, about themselves, and they get students to recruit here at these club fairs. There's also a research day, so if you're a freshman in, or a freshman to the senior in high school, you can come and research tech. And there's also club fairs here that'll show you what they have to offer. There's things like the hiking club, there's a like choir club, I think, Japanese club, and our club, New Mexico Tech GraceLife. So if you're ever here, come see us there. We usually have desserts or some kind of cookie or something. So that's all there is really up in this section. Now I'm going to show you the cafe and the cafeteria. Hi, this is the cafe, mostly known to students though as Fire and Ice. They sell and brew proudly Starbucks coffee. Here you can get anything from smoothies to coffee to snacks, and you can pay with cash or debit card, but the main form of cash here is tech dollars, and tech dollars is what you pay for if you're living in the dorms right up front, and I think that they range anywhere from like 25 to like 175 tech dollars. And so there's snacks over there, kind of like Gatorade and water. Students get that last minute if they don't want to get real breakfast here in the cafeteria. So like I said, it's with tech dollars and you can just swipe your card and they will do the transaction there for you. Also, this is our study lounge where some students come to eat here instead of eating in the actual cafeteria. There's actually a TV where if you don't have a TV, a lot of students come for like Super Bowl or whatever, just to watch sports, whatever they want to watch. Yeah, a lot of students come and study here in the daytime. It's usually pretty crowded around lunch. Also, behind this area is the computer pod. And the computer pod has a few computers that you can use. They have all sorts of software on them, like MATLAB and Maple, and every GCC computer will be equipped with that. And that'll be good for your classes, for your math classes and for those programming classes. But you can print things here, and if you print with a TCC, it's like 11 cents a paper. So if you have a printer, it's best, I think, to print at home. But if you want to print here last minute, that's the best idea. There's also this study lounge that students can come in here. There's no computers in here, but it's just another quiet place to study if you want to do that. It's fairly clean, I think, and I like coming in here. It's quiet and you can always shut this door. You also need your tech ID to get into these rooms because that's how they're operated, and they don't want random people coming in here and using that stuff. So always have that on you. It's really important to have. Okay, so now I'm going to explain the meal plans here at Tech. So at Tech, there's different housing options. There's the dorms, which consists of Driscoll South, West, and Presidents, and under all those dorms you must have at least 150 meals per semester. And so you cover all that at the beginning of the year, and that's how you decide. You can get more, I think it goes up to like 250. And so, you know, if you do the math, I think that's like 3 a day or whatever. but nobody really uses all those meals, so I would recommend maybe going a little bit lower than what they tell you. If you live in the apartment, you only have to get a minimum of 50 meals, which is what I have this semester. And, you know, I come here maybe like once or twice a week, and I've already used my meals, actually, so when you're done at the end of the year, those meals are actually forfeited. So whatever you didn't use, they don't roll over or anything, you don't get to keep them. So that's how that works. And so those meals will be attached to your tech dollar plan, like I told you about earlier. The tech dollars and your meals, they kind of coincide. Like, there's packages, and that's how that will work. You'll get, you know, I have right now is 50 meals and also 50 tech dollars. And so I think that's the minimum that I have to have living in an apartment. And so I think that, like, for the average dorm, it's probably 150 meals to 225 and maybe 75 tech dollars, which is, you know, a larger plan. So here we are going into the cafeteria right now, which is known as Chartwell's.
It's chocolate.
When you come into Chartwell's, the first thing you're going to do is swipe your card right here. And people grab a tray and plates. And so each section is kind of divided by what kind of food it is. This first section is kind of like hamburgers and fries and I guess sometimes nachos. And this is lunchtime, after lunchtime, so it's not as popular right now. But this is just kind of go with your burger if that's what you're going to have. Also, usually for lunch and dinner, they'll have all kinds of sandwich things here. They have just different breads that you can choose. They'll almost always have pizza, pepperoni is the top choice, I think. And that's always here for lunch and dinner. This is usually like the Asian section, I think. They always have like some kind of rice. Today it looks like they had apricot chicken. I don't know what that is, but it sounds good. Mixed vegetables. This section over here is just like sides and condiments, sometimes pastas. And over here is usually some kind of Mexican food, like burritos and ground meat. So, kind of just section that out. This is the salad bar over here. Oh, and the drinks, and you can get decaf, but I'm pretty sure if it's labeled outtakes, it corresponds to the tech dollars in the cafe. So you need to pay for all those things over there. There's also drinks over here. You can get fountain drinks and cups and everything. This is usually also where they have all the desserts. This table is usually filled with desserts. Cobbler. And also over here is a salad bar where you can make whatever kind of salad you want. They have crackers and all kinds of side things. This is usually here 24/7, so if you ever want a salad, it's always available for you. In the morning, in this hamburger section, they'll usually have like breakfast burritos, eggs, they'll make you omelets. They have bacon, sausage, depending on the day. They have biscuits and gravy usually too, so that's all here in the morning. Chartwell's has different times, and I believe in the morning they open up around 8:30 or 8. And they're usually open all day, but right now it's in between time, so that's why there are many students here, but they'll put out fresher things at the beginning of each meal time, so noon or 6 for lunch and dinner.